Hello, welcome back to Italian Food Boss. Today we are finally cooking a classic dish of Italian cuisine. Many of you have asked for this dish, so today is the day. Pasta alla carbonara. This is my carbonara recipe. It is quite traditional, so we are gonna do it pretty much in the original way. There are of course some variants that you can choose to adopt. I'm gonna stick to more or less the traditional way, and it's gonna be phenomenal, trust me. Pasta alla carbonara. Easy ingredients, we're gonna use today some spaghettoni, big spaghetti, pasta rummo, then of course the guanciale, which is the pig cheek, and then some eggs, some pecorino romano on top, and that's pretty much it. Let's start with the guanciale to cook our carbonara. We have this nice piece of guanciale, which is effectively the cheek of the pig. Look at this. We are going to get rid of this part, and then we are going to cut it in small slices. And this is gonna be the essential part of our carbonara. So let's start. We are getting rid of the skin outside because this is very hard and it's not gonna taste great. But we leave the fat. The fat, of course, is not gonna be very lean for our diet. But guys, you can't cook the carbonara if you're worried about the diet. And then out of this, we create some shorter and thinner slices. Now that we have sliced our guanciale for our carbonara, we are going to heat it up a bit. Of course, we don't need to put any oil in the pan because this is already quite fatty. So, medium heat, we are gonna throw our guanciale, perfectly sliced, in here. And we let it cook for a few minutes. In the meanwhile, we can focus now on the eggs. I'll show you how. All right, now for three people we want to have two whole eggs and then just one red part of the egg. With the transparent part we are gonna do some mayonnaise or something else. So that's what we do now. And now the third, we just want the red part in here. So we are gonna just save the red. You do this type of operation and then you're fine. Put the red in here. And now you start working with your whisk this way. And we're gonna add then a pecorino and a bit of pepper. Mm-hmm. we keep whisking this, and we're gonna add now the cheese, pecorino romano. Bello pecorino, nice and salty. That's what you want. You're mixing it up with the eggs in this way. Bit more. And then we also add some black pepper. Our guanciale is cooking. Now you can choose if you want your guanciale quite crispy or not. I personally prefer it quite crunchy, and therefore I'm gonna cook this a bit longer, not so much because it's almost ready. But otherwise, if you want it less crispy, you can just stop now. Okay, the water is now boiling. We have our spaghettoni rummo that we are gonna cook today. Beautiful, look at them. We put them in here and we cook them very al dente, which is about 11 minutes. So I think after 8-9 minutes, they're ready, for me at least. The pasta is very al dente, the way we like it. So now we take the spaghettoni that we want to eat, and we keep cooking them with the guanciale for another maybe couple of minutes before we merge everything in the other pan. We keep them cooking in here for a bit so that they get also all the flavor coming from the guanciale, and above all from the fat that the guanciale lost. Another 90 seconds probably, it's done. Guys, now this is when everything is coming together. We create a bit of this. Now the consistency is still quite liquid, but you will see when we mix the pasta and the guanciale, this will become a bit more solid. And we want to do this outside of the heat. So we are gonna do it on top of the pot with the water, a bagno maria, because then it's gonna be easier for us to control the liquidity of the egg. So we're ready. We mix everything in here, very important. More pecorino in case we need it, and then we keep doing this. Beautiful, look at this. Look at the cream that we are getting. Guys, please look. Huh? Oh, mamma mia. Guys, no garlic, no onion. Don't listen to these cooks that tell you to ruin such a beautiful recipe. This is ready, guys. This is ready. You don't need to add cream, absolutely not. Look how creamy this pasta is. Why do I need cream? Perfect, guys. I'm ready to eat. Wow, guys. This is the best part, look. What do I need cream? Why do I need cream? Tell these guys, no cream. Look at this. Amazing. Guys, this is how you cook a carbonara. That's how it's done in Italia. Let the likes flow, share, follow me on Instagram, YouTube, subscribe to my YouTube channel, Facebook, TikTok, Twitter. You know what I'll do, in fact? Be more pepper. And this is my plate, guys. See you. Bye.